All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back once again to the StarLadder Star Series Season 14, presented by iLeague. My name is Blue, joining me is Metis, and we are about to go live with the second map here between E-Frag and Gamers 2. Gamers 2, a little bit of a rough patch there starting off the first map, but they managed to swing it back. And again, the members of E-Frag actually brought it very, very close coming up towards the end of it, but didn't really pan out for them, unfortunately, and G2 didn't end up winning things 16-13. But now we're going to jump onto their map pick, which is Inferno.
It certainly is, and this, I feel like Inferno is a pretty important map, obviously, to win that knife on, especially against a team like G2 Kinguin. Of course, in the seventh major, where EnVyUs ended up taking it all, G2 took them to 25-21 on Inferno. So quite clearly, G2, a pretty solid Inferno team. Not bad at all. Whereas E-Frag have got a pretty good record when it comes to this map. It's not quite against the same caliber of teams. The only notable results they've got is beating Vexed twice recently on this map and Lounge Gaming. Now, no disrespect to either of those teams. They're not quite EnVyUs level teams. So I would say, again, I'm favoring G2 to take this. I think it could be close again, though.
And we're going to see that, guys, in just a little bit here. The knife round should be getting started in a moment. And, of course, the knife round actually probably going to be very, very important. We saw just how heavily both of the team's victory sort of weighed on the CT side of things. Actually, I would correct myself, weighed a little bit on the T side. So I imagine things are going to be quite interesting here. We might have sort of like a North American-style match, or at least I guess you could call this a lower-tiered match in general, where if team's CT sides aren't necessarily up to par, we could actually see the T side sort of dictating the way that things go, as is often and become the way a lot of at least North American games are played out.
Yeah, it's interesting, isn't it? Because I think a lot of maps have started to shy away from the absolutely dominating CT sides. With the hitbox changes, you know, this is something I don't hear talked about a great deal. The hitbox changes, I feel, have allowed entry fraggers to get a lot more happiness out of their, you know, out of their role. So, again, though, I would say, obviously, this is CT-sided. You're expecting a team to rack up a solid 9 or 10 rounds at least, especially now that G2 Kinguin have got this. I talked about the importance of this before. E-Frag, on the receiving end, though, I did mention this previously. They came to prominence. They became kind of a household name in CS and G-Play days by having fantastic team performances on Inferno. They were super aggressive. They landed almost every single entry frag and just bombed into sites. They had no fear, maximum disrespect. I'm curious to see if they're going to keep that up against Kinguin, because for me, that's the only way they win this game.
So here we go once again, guys. We'll see how well things play out here and see how well the members of E-Frag are able to perform, if they can keep up that rep once again. But we're starting things off here once again. We can take a look and see just how well the members of G2 are able to catch them here. Obviously, E-Frag sort of fishing for some headshots here if they could catch them peeking back over by the mid choke, but not going to happen. What is happening, though, when you look at Gamers 2 is the fact that they've started to peek themselves out a little bit more towards Banana. In fact, they very aggressively push this. In fact, I think E-Frag are sort of sitting back right now in T-Ramp, hoping that they do push out past the flower pot so they can catch some of these guys, but it looks like for the most part, at least for now, G2 are going to stop just right here. And as they pop back out, if they do want Banana, there could be a nasty surprise waiting, and indeed, that's going to be the case. Rain pops out and catches both of them.
I really do feel it. G2 Kinguin have one of the best teams when it comes to pistol rounds. Like, well, everybody's aim is ridiculous, but Jkaem gets caught napping somewhat in apps, and this is a pretty crucial frag. It allows Dreamer to wrap himself around through apps. If they land this shot onto Maikelele, things could get interesting. That's not the case. Rain comes in with another one. He's picked up three. He's hungry for another four, man, and indeed, he does get it done. So G2 Kinguin weathered the storm a tiny bit for the mid part of that round. They do win the pistol nonetheless, and this is going to put them in a great position. And for those of you asking who won, you can see at the top of your map, it is G2 Kinguin who won the first map, although it was pretty close, 16-13.
So now again, this is going to put E-Frag. They're going to go for the usual force up here with Tech9 armor, CZ armor specifically on SpyleadeR. But behind that, actually, not a whole lot of utility. You know, we only get that one smoke and flash combo. So this is going to be a really solidified, just a big five-man push. We can even see there, too, the G2 just go for the big nade stack. But they're pushed up. They're waiting for this. So Fox might have a field day if he doesn't fall back after getting hit there initially. You can just see going crazy on the spray. Empties out the bag completely, but not going to catch a single point of damage. Now they work up. There's one. There's two. Not going to find three as he falls back, but now it's Jacob's turn to party. He finds one. However, Dreamer is going to be able to pop out and find the trade before he can do any more damage. However, they've spotted this, but at the same time, SpyleadeR is going to catch an additional player, and now as they try to hold them back in, that doesn't really pan out so well. Even Rain has to fall back here a little bit too, so these players are actually quite low, and there's a considerably large chance that E-Frag could potentially clutch this out now that they've upgraded two of their guns here.
Absolutely, especially considering that, as you mentioned, two players very, very low right now from G2 Kinguin. Maikelele still on full HP. But all it takes is that one little tap to the forehead and he will be a goner. There we go. It's back to equality once more. Rain needs to wait. He's going to trade weapons. He's going to give the better, the superior M4 to his high HP. Mikail, that seems to be the correct choice. Mikail still on 100%. Can't even get the close range shot. He's spraying with a P90. 50 bullets of doom and misery is going to come good. And E-Frag do pull it back.
G2 just, to be completely honest, is getting a little bit too over-aggressive there. They pushed them a nice up and close. That car push wasn't necessarily out of place, but what unfortunately was moving all the way up through middle, trying to catch them off guard and box them in to close it out, but unfortunately they were able to bust open that box before they even got a chance to close it, essentially. Found their way back out, found so many kills, and even though they were still at a disadvantage at that point, I should say, they still managed to strike right back there, do a whole lot of damage in the process, which made the final couple kills very, very easy to pick up, so that's indeed going to be a strike back for E-Frag now, and that we'll see what they can do as G2. They're going to go for their own force up here with Deagles, P250s, and 5.7 armor buys.
Yeah, E-Frag need to definitely respect this right now from G2 Kinguin. Yes, they're definitely down, but certainly not out just yet. It just takes one of those one taps from Dennis or Makaleli, and things could get very interesting. So you're seeing this. E-Frag are playing this one slow. They're going to play together. Here finally comes the push with a minute to play with Dennis. Must be able to hear the pitter-patter of footsteps moving towards Archers. Can't connect the first 1D, but Bubble just about scampers away with his life. Now realizes probably a chance of someone being in library, but turns his back on it. Victor's waiting for the push. Jkaem meanwhile lands the 5-7 shot and gets a Galil. That's pretty significant. Second frag. I think spyleadeR had a grenade out. Things have gone horribly wrong now. Dennis is going to pull out his Deagle, lands one shot, and a second as well. And the bomb is on quad. What a catastrophe for E-Frag.
And now it's just Bubble working himself against four players, all sitting around half HP from G2, but the odds are basically gone down the toilet at this point as he peeks back out here on the wrap side. He is going to find one, takes down Makaleele, but now they know exactly where he is. The illusion of mystery is gone, essentially, from Bubble. So he's even playing this very carefully. No time left either to make this play. He would have to go man mode, working his way into the A site to try to pick up three kills and get the plant. Well, obviously the three kills would end the round, but still, he's going to choose to just sit back and save this Galil instead. And G2, I don't think they'll be able to catch him as this round closing out. Nobody's even close to the library just as of yet.
That's got to be soul destroying for E-Frag, man. It's like, yes, we got ourselves back in this map. We just got the force buying effect, and then suddenly Dennis shows up. It's like, what's up, bros? One deeks to the face all day, every day. Depressing. E-Frag, go for another force, though.
Yeah, they're definitely going to try to strike back right at this. So now that G2 have sort of brought back their own round, as we're going to be trading rounds back and forth here, we'll see exactly what E-Frag can do here. They also got two rifles in their hands this time too, so it's not necessarily this huge struggle round with Tech9 armors and whatnot that's going to be very capable. They've got two very big rifles to work with, and that could yield some results. But Dennis, waiting for the peek back over here, going to catch an easy kill onto Bubble. Takes him right out of the picture. And already that's going to be a good start for the members of G2. A lot more working inside of the apartments, however. Dreamer going to try to find a way out of Boiler, but it gets smoked by Rain, so not going to get a chance to do that just as of yet.
Familiar territory, though, for G2 Kinguin. All they know is that there's probably at least one player. They did hear a bit of movement in apps previously. That really is only half the struggle. There's still plenty of time to play with. Rain is there with the M4, looking for a second frag as well, and does connect it. Other two players pretty much forced to push through apps. They have to try and get something done from this position. That's pretty solid work from NKL, and if this bomb goes down, pretty much done his job in this 5-versus-1 scenario. So, pretty well played by him. I don't expect him to get anything done from this point. Indeed, he gets taken out, but still, this gives E-Frag a bit of a glimmer of hope for their economy. G2 Kinguin, though, will have three rounds on the board, and they are looking good.
And this is finally a sense for G2 to sort of build up their own economy here now too, now that we haven't seen the trade go back once again here. The question is whether E-Frag are kind of going to take things a little bit more laps coming into this round. He's looking, the money's still not necessarily the best, and going for another Tech9 armor round, it's going to enable them to still go for the buy in the next one, but they're still going to be stretching the dollars a little bit here, so begs the question as to whether or not doing this consistently left and right is worth it, especially now that your opponent does have it pretty consistently and they're sort of running away with things. Even we're going to see the op coming into the hands of Fox now as well. Gonna start it off for the members of E-Frag. Just gonna work their way out. Fox trying to see what he can catch back over here on Banana. And we can see that Victor's pushed up pretty heavily inside of the cubby area of it, but not gonna be able to find anything just as of yet. Spyleader, though, back out in mid. He does take some hits, and a great reaction from Fox actually shuts down Victor. Bubble finding a trade, though, back over here on the T steps as they work their way back into A.
I just felt the tremor from Victor throwing his computer out the window with that Tech 9. That should have been a kill every day of the week. It was beautiful from Fox, but Victor will be like, how is he not dead? He hit him a good few times. That being said, the bomb has gone down again to E-Frag. Even in losing rounds, they're at least getting the bomb planted. And this is another kind of force buy situation where two players only on $400 and $500 respectively with the Tech 9 armors. So is this finally going to be them tapping out? They've got the round loss coming in with that bomb plant. They could force him some AK-47s. But GQ Kinguin again survived with four players, so their economy is just building. You can see three players on over 6k can easily replenish their weapons. No issues. Here comes another force.
Yeah, and they're just going to go for the buy-up here. As we've talked about before, I mean, with them stretching the dollars this much, we can look at some players, and it is going to beg the question as to how strong the economy in terms of utility is going to be at this point. Not the best, to be honest. I mean, yeah, you've got four smokes to work with, but in terms of Molly, I think we're going to bring two Mollies into play. So with the exception of spyleadeR, it's actually not going to be as bad as I was expecting it to be. But nonetheless, you know, you save up for one of those rounds. Just take it nice and easy. Again, these ecos finally aren't really working out. If they had just gone for the save right there, then they could have an op in their hands, and who knows what else at that point. So G2 again open things up with the first kill. It's going to be Maikelele finding bubble, and as of yet no additional progress being made by E-Frag, as most of their players have pushed up alt mid with an attempt to get inside of the apartments.
Yeah, definitely see where you're coming from. Again, I feel like this is one of the issues that E-Frag have consistently had. They're force buying pretty much every single round, and if they're getting more out of it, if they get more bang for their buck, I can kind of understand. But a couple of these rounds have gone pretty one-sided to G2. So again, this is where it kind of comes in with Bubble. He's not an out-and-out AWPer in the purest sense of the word. Like, he's happy enough just to go with the AKs. And I feel like that in itself could force E-Frag into more force buys than maybe they'd normally have. If you've got a straight-up AWPer, you're like, no, guys, we need to save up for the AWP on Bubble. He can't afford one. Let's save. Let's get a healthy buy next round. That being said, 35 seconds left. Here comes the push. Victor does get the upper hand onto Vox, who goes for the re-peak. Did land the flashbang, and suddenly things are turning back in the favor of E-Frag. Two frags just like that make it a third. NKL seems to have dusted off the cobwebs that he had on Dust 2, and he is now outfragging left, right, and center. Dennis and Jacob, your last two remaining players. There's enough economy to rebuy here for G2 Kinguin, so they may be baited in for going on this retake. I feel, though, exit frags probably the order of the day.
Yeah, you can see Jacob taking his time there, going through Mexico. So probably not going to end up happening, as they're going to line up for those exits once again. And Jacob's actually in a really good spot to do it. He could find Dreamer. He's going to catch him. Now going to get a second too, but doesn't want to directly challenge that just as of yet. Gives them a little bit more room to breathe, but catches them on the way down for the staircase. So there's going to be two easy kills. They even it out. And Dennis looking to see if he can find anything from library, but not going to be the case. Jacob might have a chance to find another one, but NKL, for the time being, has successfully dodged him. And I do believe, although it's going to be very close, he will be able to make it out of that round alive.
So now E-Frag, after getting themselves a round on the board, will have a decent buy-up with full grenades. Again, no big deal, though. I don't think AWP is necessarily completely crucial on T-side, especially if you have strats that are going to be very smoke-heavy. You know, you're going to be up in the face, up in the grill, very close claustrophobic confrontations, which E-Frag do like. However, Fox is going to be running again with the AWP. This time he's peeking down Banana. He's typically lurking around arches as well. Maikelele just walks around the corner, claims himself a frag. Smokes and flashes landing down mid rain. It's his turn to shine and step up to the plate, but it's Dennis who comes in for two frags, leaving Bubble all by his lonesome. And look where that bomb's dropped for you. That is horrendous.
Yeah, this round's, I mean, not only that, but obviously the 1-on-4 that's now in play here. It's just Bubble trying to work something and not a whole lot left for him to do. G2 just kicking into full throttle there. As soon as they spot one player, E-Frag try to respond back and get a couple kills, but it just doesn't pan out so well. So this is Bubble working against a very futile round at this point. He's picked up one kill, so he's definitely looking to do this at the very least. Maikelele's probably going to fall too. Great movement coming out here from Bubble. Good job moving around the map, really throwing the members of G2 off. But now they've got to play a little bit safer, because this is definitely a palatable round at this point for the final member left alive. Bubble's going to pop out though, and finally Jacob finds the angle that's needed to shut things down. And by the way, folks, I don't know if Meta's is getting it, but we do know that the GoTV is lagging a little bit. I think it's sort of settled itself down now, but if it does come back, there's another relay I can try. I don't know exactly what the dealio is with the lag on the server, but hopefully it has resolved itself and it shouldn't be a problem for the rest of the match.
Yeah, I was getting it a bit earlier as well, for sure, so hopefully it's not too bad for you guys that are watching. I should have known as soon as I said up in the grill, we'd have like 10 people spamming grill in chat, because, you know, it's Twitch, why not? 1-for-1 trade, E-Frag, poor weapons, and the 1-for-1 trade normally I'd say would favor the terrorists, not so much here. G2 Kinguin were pretty happy with this. The bomb's been dropped. Maikelele just charges in again. The hyper-aggression paying off for the European team. That being said, Dream has answered back. Two players low for E-Frag. So definitely not out of the woods just yet, but G2 Kinguin is going to spread them pretty thin.
So Maikelele gets out of there. Actually, sort of created Popflesh too to clear out things and just make sure he isn't followed by the rest of these guys. And it is going to be an even match in terms of the player count. But I mean, look at the health pools of two out of three of these final E-Frag players. They don't really have anything at all. Dreamer and Viktor down to 11 HP. Granted, Maikelele is going to be low, but there goes one of them, and they're lined up ready for this one. Thankfully, Fox is not going to peek. He's got his attention drawn elsewhere, just to make sure that there isn't a push coming outside of the apartments and whatnot. So they will be able to retreat this second player. Over on towards Banana to work his way onto that B site, but they have a feeling of what's going on. Even Jkaem now is going to rotate into assist, and he's going to be the big player here. Maikelele down at 17 HP. Unfortunately, he can't really afford to pop right back out. And now that Jkaem has taken down one of the higher health pool players, not a whole lot left to do. Actually, Dreamer is going to steal away that kill. Catches him switching weapons, so a little bit of a surprise there. This is going to draw a Fox over, but very, very patient for Maikelele. He's going to pop out. He does fall to Dreamer, so this is not possible at this point, but he peeks out, misses the opening shot, and Fox is finally going to shut him down before he clutches out the round.
Yeah, I feel kind of sorry for him. He had 8 seconds, so he kind of had to go for that peek there. He didn't know exactly where Fox was coming from. That just played to the strengths of the AWP straight up. So a good hold there for G2 Kingwin. Very, very close, though. And also, you caught me out, chat. I am going to hold my hands up. When I said European team, what I meant is that E-Frag are all Bulgarians, whereas G2 Kingwin obviously have players all over Europe. But yeah, it sounded kind of stupid. So I got called out. I bow my head in shame.
Bulgaria's not in Europe.
You can feel free to report me, I'd understand. And now report Blue for that joke. Because right. You know you're going to get hatred for that right now, don't you? The Bulgarians are going to come down hard on you for that.
I'm sure the chat hates me well enough already today. So, so E-Frag taken, I believe, their tactical pause at this point, as things unfortunately not going very well on this T side, as I personally sort of expected things to go, comparatively to what we saw on that previous map. Where we were seeing, obviously, E-Frag didn't really do as well on their CT side as they were doing on their T side. G2, obviously, a little bit better, so it sort of sways things into their direction anyway, just because of the fact that this is a very, very CT-centric map when you look at things. So, just waiting to see exactly what these guys are doing. I believe this is the attack pause, because it would make sense to do so at this point. They've fallen behind pretty well, down by 4 points, and they're going to be on an eco here, so if they do go for sort of a discussion, then they're going to have a good chance to sort of sit back and sort of let whatever they've decided on doing sort of gel with them going into this next round. And if they do want to make any changes, they can discuss that here in this round, which is basically going to be a garbage round for the most part. When you look at their money, this should be an easy 7th point for G2.
Absolutely. The thing with E-Frag, though, I would always agree with what you just said. With E-Frag, you never know. They could just go for a force. Honestly, I've seen crazier things from these guys before. It wouldn't make a lot of sense because they only have 2 rounds of round loss coming in, but there we go. Dreamer's like, what's up, bros? Glil. Come at me. Please. I'm trying to figure out why you do that, and I've got nothing. I'm drawing a blank.
So here comes E-Frag now once again. Gonna go for that force up as we, actually, I didn't think this was gonna happen, but you've proven me wrong once again, so they're just gonna go right for it at this point. G2 as well. An interesting weapon choice, at least in the case of Maikelele, is he's going to play from within side of the apartments. He has to get aggressive because of this, though, but that hasn't been a problem so far for him in most of this half as of yet, so I don't think he's going to be too thrown off by that, but we will see there. A nade comes out from Fox. Unfortunately, now he's trapped, though, so he's got to pull off some big kills. Gets the support from his teammate, but NKL's going to drop him. Fox with a no-scope, though, catching NKL, looking for another one. He's going to grab it on a bubble, and another one over here on the spyleadeR. Just one left alive. It's going to be Dreamer, and he shuts him down as well. That's the ace from Fox, holding back by the car.
Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Yes, it was a poor buy from E-Frag, but it's an AWP. It wouldn't matter if they had AKs and full armor or nothing. That's still fantastic AWPing from Fox. I'm watching that back on the stream right now. Unbelievable. What a beast.
And there you go, Fox. Once again, the showstopper, as we can call him now, back over here by Banana. And this is going to completely break E-Frag now, because they've gone for that force and it just fails miserably. Now they finally go into a full eco round, and hey, they actually get more kills in the previous round already. 2-for-2 trade has started. Maikelele tries to jump outside of the window Batman style with that shotgun, but doesn't kill a single player. And now that's going to even things back out into a 2-on-2. Jkaem sneaking through New Mexico, so he might be able to find a free kill in a bubble if he stays at his current angle. And that's going to make this round a lot easier, but he does get behind cover just in time. And now the plant's already come off on the A set as well, so the time is ticking. And G2 are not going to have a whole lot of time to relax if they want to go for this retake.
Oh, the XM to the forehead. Overkill, if ever you've seen it. Bubble from behind. And G2 Kingwin will concede a third round. That P250 shot, though, was pretty beautiful in second mid. And G2 Kingwin now, after being in such a commanding position economically speaking, backs against the walls for them. Mag 7 coming in. Fox doesn't have a lot of funds to play with. He's going to go for a P90. So this is E-Frag's chance to get themselves back into this map. It's not going to be easy. They've still got decent weapons on the board. There's a glimmer of hope.
And now for E-Frag as well. Just going to press themselves forward again. No reason to rush things just as of yet. Is again, the economy's sort of been back and forth here. They've had some rounds where they've done decent damage and some rounds where not. So they're not 100% sure as to where things are standing. The members of G2, though, get some good opening damage here on a Viktor, but Viktor is actually able to find the headshot there on a Maikelele from inside of that little window there, so that takes him down, and again, a good start to the round from E-Frag. So far, not a whole lot that's been stricken back onto these guys besides that earlier damage that had gone into Viktor, and they kind of have the ball in their court in terms of where they want to take things. As G2, they've definitely shifted a lot of their player base back over here towards A. They're expecting it to come in from there, and in fact, if just one player from E-Frag goes to scout at what's happening over there on B, they can easily just see, oh, this is an open site. We can easily take this at this point, and they're holding back now, trying to contemplate if they actually want to do that or not, but seems as though they're actually just going to go straight forward here with the A take, which could lead to being a mistake here, especially with that shotgun still in play from Jkaem if he can pick up a couple kills with this.
Both players as well positioned on quad. Once that smoke clears, Dennis could be in the money here. Dreamy gets the frag onto Jkaem, and again, because there's been so much time that elapsed between the frags and now, there's a chance that maybe E-Frag could have rotated, so it's really important for G2 Kingdom to get that information. Yes, they've got it, but simply outnumbered, outgunned. And indeed, we'll get another round going the way of E-Frag. And now here comes the real curse for G2 Kinguin. No economy to play with. No weapons at all. Maybe a couple upgraded pistols, but that's going to be all she wrote for G2 Kinguin and E-Frag. They are right back into this, Blue. They have every chance of putting up at least, I would say, 5, 6, 7 rounds are doable from this point for them.
And Spyler even knows just how low that money's gotten now, finally. So he's actually going to go for the MAC-10 buy this time, just to try and stack up a little bit of extra cash. I'm assuming he'll be leading the charge, too. And this is just going to be a straightforward play from Banana, working their way in. They do molly themselves out initially, so they're not going to be able to push for it just yet. But a great nade, already bringing Fox in at 30 HP. Spyler looking for the finishing touches, but not going to catch it just as of yet. Now he does, though. There's one kill for him. Looking for Jkaem on the way in. Jkaem trying to play jiggle peek with him, but not going to pan out so well. Tries to run back, jumping away, but SpyLeader catches the headshot. The defenses on the B side are gone. And for the members of G2, again, this take has already happened. So there's not really anything they can do to try and stop it with the guns they have.
Yeah, no hope whatsoever.
And
should be stacking on A.
Yeah, the final two players that are already on A, taking some interesting positions. Perched
like
up
gargoyles.
On top. Yeah. The Guardians of Pit.
I like it.
Just a waiting.
Are they going to get any frags, though?
Oh, there.
Awkward? Okay.
What? I don't know.
Emo gargoyles, I guess?
I don't know if they realize they could still come and kill them, but I guess
shoot for Gaben?
They don't care much about those P250s.
Understandable, I guess.
Oh, actually, yeah, they only shot the ones that had default pistols, so I guess
yeah.
Doesn't actually matter.
Dennis is still strong with the P250. He's feeling good about himself right now. Man, I was hoping that Gargoyle setup would pay out dividends there for G2 King and we just see like a meat grinder come in, but no. I'm so sad right now. And G2 Kinguin not going to be sacrificing their firepower for grenades, so they're just going to go for a full-on assault rifle buy-up. This does leave them a little bit low on nades and no defuse kits. So again, E-Frag could easily crush this defense. If they just get through onto a site, the retake game is going to be very poor for G2 Kinguin. Are they going to play aggressively as a result of that and try and take it to the terrorists? Yes, they are. But E-Frag calling is playing passively and reaping the reward. Two kills for NKL. B's open. That's going to force out at least one player to rotate across. And the grenades are landing as well. What a fantastic round for E-Frag this is turning out to be.
Perfect dead-on kill with the nade comes out from E-Frag, and now they've definitely got control of this round at this point. Dennis and Rain both split up. One's in pit back over here on A, another one trying to push up Banana a little bit to get somewhat of an aggressive angle, but all the pressure is going to shift itself into A in just a couple moments. Dennis will have to try to go for a flank, but again, still 2-on-5. Only really having done decent damage to MKL. Bubble sitting at 58, but still that's easy to manage, and Rain misses his first chance to find a kill. Immediately shut down by SpyLeader coming out on the headshot from the AK, and now Dennis, to be honest, might just be better serve trying to save this at this point, but will position himself forward, is going to run, maybe try to find Bubble, gets him on the off angle, so he's going to catch that headshot, and I'll look for a little bit more here, but no way in heck is he going to be able to go for that retake, unfortunately.
And with his economy as it is, he really won't want to fancy this either. The issue, though, is pretty much what we're seeing on the map right now. Even if Dennis does pick up this frag onto Viktor, he's got two terrorists flanking behind him. They know exactly where he is, he's got 12 HP, his days are numbered. And finally, he will be put out of his misery from NKL. So 6 rounds now up for E-Frag. And this is already a pretty solid T half, and it could just get better from here, because again, G2 Kingwin, after going for that full buy of M4s with the grenades, have left very little in their back pocket to dig into. So again, it's a mag 7 for Jkaem. And the rest of the team are not going to let this one slip with just Deagle. So is Jkaem going to be playing aggressively, I wonder, with that mag 7, trying to get something done for his team?
I think that's going to be the name of the game here. They push forward. Fox is even sitting behind him with a Deagle too, so he's going to hug close corner or sit behind the sandbags. Wait for the push. Fox will give the signal, and then it's basically just going to be a booby trap. We'll see if they can catch them, but E-Frag not really playing over towards Banana, at least at this current point in time, so this could all be for naught, essentially, here. And we can see Fox actually get some damage on the NKL. Almost takes him down, bringing him pretty close. Down to 16 HP, but not going to be able to execute him just yet, and a whole lot of noise being made there by alt mid, as E-Frag once again just try to find a way into there. Haven't decided as of yet. This is a pretty default setup. They just sit here. They wait for that extra aggression to come out at the beginning of the round, but they're not going to make any commitments until right about now, where they do decide to finally push themselves in towards middle.
That's exactly it, Blue. You hit them on the head. They wanted to just see if the poking, probing style of G2 Kingdom was going to come through again, if they could just capitalize on that. It turns out it doesn't matter anyway, because they're just going to force on through. Two players remain, one of which still has the Mag 7 in his hands. 40 seconds, bomb will be planted on A soon, unless Rain can pull off one of the plays of a lifetime. There's the first 1D connecting. He knows at least where one more player is. He lands a second. Surely this is not possible. He's now going to get encircled. Oh my goodness, man. I was hoping so much that he pulled that off.
So the big question with all this too, after he spots all these players, is like where the hell has Jkaem been? Like, Jkaem is just now getting himself in the library when he could have easily gotten here 5 to 10 seconds ago when that sort of Deagle exchange was going on. He had to have made the call at that point, but it just doesn't happen. And Jkaem could have come in as a bit of a surprise to help things out a little bit with the shotgun, but he's coming in far too late. That could have actually been a little bit more palatable to do some damage, but now he's kind of stuck inside the library and he can't do anything.
Yeah, maybe a bit of indecision creeping in there from G2 Kingwin. I almost feel like Jkaem wanted to just go for the exit, so try and save the Mag 7. But pushing into library there, like, what is the use of that? Either you need to follow up on your teammate straight away and make sure that retake is in, like, fully commit to it, or fully commit to just backing off and saving. Like, either or, you can't do a hybrid of both, otherwise that happens. G2 Kingwin will have a half-decent buy here. In fact, it's more than half-decent. It's actually pretty solid. But again, they're lacking on a bit of grenades. They've got a FAMAS on Jkaem. There's an open play on Fox. We've already seen what he's capable of doing here on Banana with it.
MKL again, entry fragging for this team, moves forward, but he doesn't expect Jkaem to be there by sandbags, so he is going to drop with his knife out. SpyleadeR does get the trade again, so no harm done at the end of the day. They still hold a man advantage, but as they move in here now, Dennis is going to look for the quick trade, hopefully trying to drop this bomb carrier, but he's got to be a little bit more cautious as he rounds around this corner, looking for the pickup on a Victor. He's going to find it, but the Molly's going to keep him here for the time being, moving out. He's going to pick up a second on a SpyleadeR, and now it's just Bubble stuck inside of the mini pit over here now, back over by the generator, or by the grill as it actually is on this map, and now as he finds one more kill, Dennis is going to trade him back out, but of course plenty of time left here as they pick up that final kill. That's going to be G2 closing this one out finally, and although it's going to be very, very slim, they will indeed hold the lead coming out of this first half.
Yeah, Dennis just beast-moding that round with three return frags. You know, the first two kills go down, Fox gets picked off, and then the I think it was Jkaem who was behind the sandbags then died as well, and it was looking so rough. You're thinking, okay, E-Frag, you've got the 8-7 halftime lead. This is a fantastic halftime scoreline. It's still pretty solid on 7, but I already talked about this before. For me, one of the main weaknesses from E-Frag right now is their CT sides on maps. So it can be exploited. It can definitely be punished. We've already seen they are very happy to force buy on CT. That can really hurt you in the long run. So this pistol's pretty important, I'd say, for E-Frag. If they win this, they've got every chance at converting it to the map win. If they lose, I'm not so convinced.
They're going to press forward now, trying to hold things off. So far it goes well, but it's traded back out. Fox finding both of the kills for the members of G2. SpyleadeR picks up one more, but Rain comes out on top too. He finds another kill here, bringing it down to just two left alive here for the members of E-Frag. It's going to be Dreamer and MKL. Rain holding here, looking to find that frag on MKL, but he does back off, sitting behind the highway area for the time being, waiting for his teammate to come in, but peeks out again a little bit too early there. That's going to be Jkaem finding the kill. He does take some more damage, but it's going to be Rain to close things out. And that will be Gamers 2 holding on to the lead for quite some time now, as they will pick up the pistol here on the second half as well.
Yeah, it's a huge pistol for G2. That's going to hurt E-Frag. Of course, they go for the force. This is pretty standard CT play. You're expecting everyone to do this. Interestingly enough, though, four CZs. That is not something you see a great deal of. It's normally pretty much split down the middle between 5-7 users and CZs, but four of them here. And the 1-5-7 for NKL. Now, don't get me wrong, the CZ is still a fantastic pistol in the right hands. It is still phenomenally strong. The 5.7, I feel, gives you that one-tap power and obviously a lot more bullets as well. And it can quickly whip that out and suddenly get up in the face of your opposition. I realize that's going to get taken completely wrong from Twitch chat. Deal with it.
Well, now that you highlighted, they're just going to do that. You can't do that. Indeed. Right? You got to subtly sneak it in. Act like you have no clue what they're talking about when they do it. Anyway, G2 trying to work their way in. That's actually a really good smoke work here too. Just to highlight that, when you look at Maikelele, they smoke it just so they can see that little bit of porch corner as they pop out. So unfortunately, that's not gonna catch them off guard. What will do with this though is spyleadeR popping back out over there from CT, and they're gonna find a combination of two kills. Rain though trades them back out as he works his way into the B site. It'll be left to a 3-on-3, but again, not a whole lot of upgrades going on to the members of EFRAG, and KL is the only player that gets anything, and that's a P90, which the AKs are more than likely going to beat at long range, but Bubble being a little creative with this does get some damage back over here on Rain, and Fox is pretty low too, but there's one going down, looking for another one. NKL coming in on the flank, and again, Bubble's still very much alive and well at this point, so he's going to catch them off guard. NKL picks up one kill, we saw Bubble find another one, and now all this pressure shifts to Fox. He's had to sit back because he's been so low, but he's going to pop out, can't tick down the P90 though, and that P90 is going to end up saving them at the end of the round. They'll strike back, but I don't actually think they have enough time to defuse that bomb, so they're gonna have to go away. And G2, thankfully, just because they delayed it long enough, they're gonna pick up the 10th point.
Yeah, but that's gonna send shockwaves down the spine of G2 Kinguin, because that should have been a clear-cut round there, and just things went horribly wrong. Plus the fact that EFRAG did significant damage to the economy of G2 Kinguin as well. Sure, they don't have fantastic economy themselves, but they saved, I should say, two weapons. And that kind of forces their hand into this force buy. So two P90s on the hands of G2 Kinguin. No head armor on Fox. So he's a sitting duck for the likes of those CZs, P90, and FAMASes. Let's see if it plays out, though. NKL in a great position catches Maikelele!
How does Maikelele get that frag?
NKL whiffs absolutely crazily there. Had the kill, but for some reason, shook his cursor around at the end of it and missed it. Missed the final little single bullet that was needed to kill him, so... Now we did see another trade code come out from EFRAG, but Dennis is going to shut down this pushback over here too. Rain even pops into library, so this attempt to come in there to retake some control just fails miserably. Fox catches Dreamer out too, and I mean, G2 are just positioned for this perfectly at this point. Bubble's going to be the final player left alive. All he has to work with is the kill that he got on Jkaem, so he's got that AK, but that's all he's got back over here now, so this is easily another round for G2.
Was it NKL that we saw on Dust 2 do a similar thing as well?
Mm-hmm.
On long? Oh man, that's rough.
That was when I think he peeked out long doors and almost killed somebody there, but then again did the same exact thing, shifted away at the last second because he thinks he got the kill, but didn't actually
happen. Maikelele, he's such a troll. Brain's tapping to see if he can get any ridiculous one taps, and Maikelele just sits in his face with 4 HP, almost daring him to team kill him. He's gonna die. Yeah, he dies off the bomb anyway, so I don't even at this point understand what life is.
So G2 now having a comfortable lead here on their T side. Just coming off of this round here. EFRAG unfortunately not gonna be able to go for another buy just as of yet. It's gonna be an eco round, so this could be a 12th point for G2. And again, they're just taking it as full rifles here at this point too, not really working for an op or anything. We talked about this a little bit on the previous half about why we weren't really seeing all that much from EFRAG. I mean, to put it bluntly, I mean, this is a really hard map to op on, so at least from the T side's perspective, so it sort of explains it right from the beginning. But anyway, we're gonna see this starting off here. Bubble holds strong, picks up two kills. He did lose his teammate Viktor back over there by Sandbags, but because they have the three-man stack here, Bubble with that AK doing some absolutely beautiful work, he's gonna pick things off. However, Jkaem striking right back along with Fox, they pick up two more kills. And they're actually going to move Fox back over here inside of Arches to try and catch a higher rotation. Unfortunately, the bomb has been left down over here, sitting on the T-ramp, so they've got to fall back, sort of give up their control of A to move towards this, but EFRAG as well have not actually moved in to rotate against this as of yet. They're kind of assuming that this round's over at this point, maybe looking to save, as they're just stuck inside of the B site.
Well, one way this round could open back up again is if Fox goes into the site and dies, and we go back to a 2-on-2. If that happens, then there's every chance this round is still doable. That being said, Bubble, did he show himself? I wasn't actually watching from his perspective. I was watching from Dennis's, who does have the bomb. But I thought for a second that G2 Kinguin were going to stack all three players onto the B side where Bubble is. Confrontation here between him and Fox, and it's going to be Fox who comes out on top, landing the AK one tap to the forehead of Bubble. 12-7, your scoreline. Here comes a full buy from EFRAG. Interested to see if Bubble goes for the AWP, and he won't. So it kind of goes into what I was saying before. He is a guy that, although he is, you know, quote-unquote, the AWPer for EFRAG, he often won't use it.
So this is going to be one of the last few chances here for EFRAG when you look at their economy realistically. Not going to have a whole lot of money left in excess if G2 come out on top here. That'll set them up to 13 points, probably 14 if we do see EFRAG go for an eco directly after this. And they're going to have one more big gunner on to try and stop them. Thankfully, this one might be a good chance to do it in itself as Bubble picks up the opening kill, hiding just outside of the mid choke. He's going to be able to find Fox out. Takes a bit of heat in the process of this, but nothing else has really been revealed as of yet. He only finds that one kill, so we're not going to be able to see a jerk rotation coming out from E-Frag just as of yet.
Yeah, not going for the over-aggression here. Not playing themselves out of position. Bubble lands the shot through the smoke onto Maikelele. Pretty big frag. Drops G2 King Win to just three players, but all three players pretty healthy. They still have plenty of grenades to use. E-Frag almost in a perfect position, though, in terms of where their players are. They even got that fourth floater in this former spy leader who is starting to fill in the gaps through arches. So four players on A. And here comes one of them through onto the arch's side. He gets fragged from Rain, who almost was shooting like he wasn't expecting to land that shot there. Turns back around to double take. He's like, wait a second, did I just land that shot? Yes, you did, Rain. Two versus four, and they're both pushing through onto the site. Dennis is the last remaining player. He's getting tapped through the box, gets finished off from Bubble, who connects with his fourth frag in that round. 12-8 now, the score.
How about the end there? Two players on CT side in pit. They don't even do anything. They just let Bubble. They're like, you got this, man. We'll just let you close this one out. And he just sprays them down one by one. No reaction at all from the two E-Frag players from pit, so... Casually, Bubble just picks up four kills there on that round. A very nice shot through the smoke, too. Really good intuition there after catching the flash. I could see he was sort of tapping it before, and then he goes for the retap there as we actually see G2's players push back through it, and he catches him there on that attempt. So that's a really good kill, but it is very much so warranted by his play, as it was a pretty predictable spot for a player to be in. So now for G2, they are going to force things up here. Not going to be a full buy, unfortunately. It's a full buy as much as they can afford it, of course, but two Tech Nines in place. They're not going to have the full AK force that they're looking to go for here on this half. And E-Frag now actually going to be given a good chance coming off of that last round pretty cleanly. I think they kept four alive at the end of it. Indeed, that was the case. With four players being left alive, this is a good chance for them to finally build up their own economy now.
Absolutely, yeah. So it's vitally important if they want to come back in this round. This is the first step. First rung up the ladder to success, as it were, and Bubble again holding down the fort here on arches. Fox going in by his lonesome, had no backup there. Can understand why he'd go for that though, trying to catch E-Frag unawares. And speaking of which, Maikelele and Rain both tag teaming each other through. They're getting Tech 9 frags, and just like that, E-Frag go from such a good position to a terrible one. All three players stacked together. Dreamer's gonna land the first frag back onto the site. There's Bubble as well. The bomb is also dropped in a precarious position. This is by no means easy. Jkaem whiffs his opportunity to take this back. The G2 King win, 1 versus 3, 20 seconds. Maikelele has to pull off a miracle play here with the M4. 15 seconds now, he's finally got the bomb. He's gonna move back to the site. Bubble playing this one perfectly. He's gonna wait by this time, trying to bait out Maikelele, who is going to land that first shot. 6 seconds now. He's going to have to get both these frags. He can't afford to get the bomb planted just yet. NKL goes into the frag. Finally gets it done. Just ahead of time, I think. Maikelele shouldn't have been hampered with his economy. Indeed, he wasn't. If that was a second later, that would have been absolutely brutal for G2 Kingman. But they still lose nonetheless.
You could see there even at the end of the round, too. It was actually, E-Frag could have actually done nothing about that if they wanted to really screw with him a little bit there. You could see he just pops right out and pulls his knife out, like blood for the blood god, basically, there at the end of the round as he gets dropped. So, E-Frag a little bit too quick on the nerves. If they had waited just about another second or so, they would have left him with a lot less cash. But he actually outplays them in that situation, as he's going to get the money bonus at the end of the day. But again, it's a lot of aggression coming out from the T side here. Right at the beginning of the round, spyleadeR able to put a whole lot of damage on Rain. Brings him down to 5 HP, not going to be enough to execute him, and spyleadeR gets a little bit jittery, so he does fall back. Just playing it safe behind the smoke for the time being, but nonetheless, this is going to be the eco push coming out from G2, moving all the way up banana here. Jkaem also making some progress too, and look at this. This is throwing the rotation off so badly. Everybody from E-Frag is biting on this. They're moving over. They're only really going to leave Viktor in the general vicinity of this, but actually, it looks like G2 are going to fall back and go over towards the A set anyway. They don't realize how empty it's been left at this point. And they've got to go back, as they're all the way, already like halfway up middle, they've got to go back onto B anyway.
What an awkward round this has been. Just constant rotations all the time. And it seems that G2 Kingwin are going to try and force their way onto B side. Spyleader is there, Fox holding the close angle, sees the barrel of the gun sticking through, converts that to a frag. Didn't hop across to get the M4. He has his teammates in the back of his mind. He's going to go back in with a Tech 9. The aim punch was real. And Viktor, with two quick fire frags, leaves Maikelele on 1 HP. Not for much longer. NKL is there. But again, G2 Kingwin in effectively an eco, get the bomb planted.
Yeah, that was because I don't really leave a whole lot of defense there. Like I said before, this round could have gone a completely different way had they have just gone straight forward with that B tick there. They had no way to know, of course, that the fake there from Jkaem worked out as brilliantly as it did, pulling almost everybody off the site over towards A. But had they gone straight forward with that, that could have been a completely different outcome to the round, as they would have had so much more time to line up post-plant situations. And obviously, again, that could have led to a lot more frags going the direction of G2. But it doesn't happen. And again, they come off of that eco with the plant, so they're going to be able to segue this directly into another buy round. Full utility, pretty much everything they could ask for this time as well. With E-Frag responding in kindly with the same exact thing.
Well, wanted to peek. You could tell he wanted to peek, but played it smart, played it disciplined. He probably could have got that frag, but he was worried in case there's more players there and the grenades could come in and he could just get pushed. Instead, playing the slower game. Here comes the set play on towards pit. Flashes through onto archers as well. And G2 Quingen going for the push. I think the flash was just a split second too late. Dreamer did catch a glimpse of Fox and just held down his trigger. Second frag coming in. He's looking for a third as well. Bubbles on the site. Very passive position. But it is going to get the upper hand onto Denison. What a shutout performance this is from E-Frag. They don't lose any players, and that was a rifle round.
G2 just have absolutely no clue what comes back in there, too, in terms of, like, what was happening. When that take began, you could just look at G2's players. They had no clue where the shots were coming from. Either the player playing from that little tiny pit corner, just picking up the shots. I think it was, like, spyleadeR that found those that time. Just picking them off one by one. They had no clue where that fire was coming from. And then we could even see there, I didn't catch one of the kills, but towards the end there, NKL finding that one inside of the long haul there, too. Just completely catches them off guard. They're not expecting a player to be up on balcony, so the comms are off. And overall, just the game sense is a little bit off from G2 in that round. They were not ready for that much of a defense from E-Frag, and they just shut it down.
That's it, exactly, in a nutshell. And we're not expecting these positions. Dreamer, I think, is the standout player in that round, but the first two kills that he picks up are huge. If he doesn't land either of them, if Fox actually takes him down, that CT side for me just crumbles. So, mad props to Dreamer. It forces G2 Kinguin into a half-buy with Tech-9 and armor. They will be able to get 8Ks next round. They do have round loss coming in, four rounds of round loss coming in actual facts. Nearly max. That grenade down mid doesn't really do any damage. But can G2 Kinguin just force the issue? Can they just push the envelope on this B side? It seems to be where they're stacking right now. And they do have enough smokes to get CT side off, maybe coils if they so fancy. They've got flashes as well. It's going to be a close one.
They're going to go right for it here too. So spyleadeR and Viktor, they've got to be ready for this one right from the beginning of the round. As this is probably just going to be a straight up explosion onto the B site. No rotations are nearby. If this take happens quickly enough, they could potentially call this for a save as well, but they're gonna move in. There is a molly from the CT side of things that reacts, but they have to push through it anyway, so we can see them taking some hits. Another molly comes down. Victor's gonna jump on top of Spools. He picks up one kill. Bubble finding another one now as they started to wrap themselves in, and he's gonna pick up an additional kill. Viktor safely falling back over here towards the grass, gonna pick off Fox down to 8 HP, and now they're moving back in for the retake at this point too. Jkaem able to find one more, but just over here to his right is spyleadeR, and after he loses his teammate, he's gonna be able to pick up the additional kill to give E-Frag the tie point. Finally, they're gonna tie things up at 12. And now poised to maybe take the lead here, but G2 have another gun round before that can happen.
Man, did Bubble just land a headshot while falling down there through the smoke? I didn't quite catch it, but that was ridiculous if he did.
If he did, I unfortunately did not see it either, as I'm a slave to the auto director.
Yeah. He got two kills through smoke. I'm not sure if the first one was while he was falling. If it was, then geez. Beast. Meanwhile, though, there's the entry frag. This time, spyleadeR has been caught out. Viktor, it's all on you, sir. Can you pull this off for your team? Can you buy up enough time for the rest of his team? The answer is a resounding yes. Two frags in. Bubble's now going to come through again. Crab walking his way to victory. Hasn't quite landed that. Fox was super low, and his crosshair seemed to be around the same area. So the bomb has been planted. This retake is doable from E-Frag, though. They've still got two Molotovs to play with, one of which has just been thrown out onto Garden. And so has the second. Pushing through the Molotov here. Bubble takes damage, but this catches Maikelele. He was not expecting that. Meanwhile, the answer comes back in the form of Fox, who's in a 1v2 with 9 HP. One of these players is low. He's picked it up, but the Molotov lands next to him, and it doesn't matter anyway because Dreamer's there, and E-Frag have taken the lead here on Inferno, and that may be the first time they've done this.
So close at the end of it there too. We saw the final player from G2 getting, you know, he picks up this one kill, but then the molly comes in, so he's forced to go out of his hidey hole, essentially back over there by Nubox. And from that point forward, he's wide in the open. He's already lost a lot of his HP, so he has no choice. That was essentially an unavoidable situation for him after he found that first kill. Nothing he could do. So E-Frag, great job setting that up. Great team play from these guys. They do bring it down very low, so not going to do them any favors for their economy, but thankfully it's already in a great position when you look at it here. 10k on one of their players, so they still have quite a bit of excess, and they can afford to make plays like that if it means taking taken a lead as they do have now. And again, aggression back over here on Banana. Makalele is going to get dropped by Viktor. There's an attempt to find a response from Rain now pushing up towards it, but not really going to fare too well here as they still have the defense and they haven't even been challenged as of yet.
These grenades on point as well. They're not doing the most damage, but they're keeping G2 Kingwin at bay. The problem there is that Bubble then goes for the peek, and for me, that's a completely unnecessary peek. You're a player up. You're looking good. You've naded out there. You know they're going to be kept at bay. Peaks gets killed. It's a 3-on-3, however. Maybe that's not going to make any difference here in this round. Maybe E-Frag can still keep the sight down, and so far it's looking good. Reigns the last player. He's been headshotted from spyleadeR, who comes in with two sick headshots. And E-Frag take its second round lead. G2 Kingwin could go for the force, but it's not going to be a fantastic one.
They kind of have to, though, because now E-Frag's at 14 points. So unless they just want to take in an OT, which, again, wouldn't be the worst thing in the world. They've already got one map on the board here. If they just want to close it out here and play for the tie, they could do so. But again, considering, as you've mentioned before, they haven't really been too keen on sort of going for the op buy-up just in this half. And neither of the other team, either E-Frag, really haven't been wanting to do it on their T side. So since this hasn't really been a choice for these players, it just is going to look like since they can get 5 AKs, they're just going to go for it here. Try to win it outright by striking back, but already things not starting off so well. Viktor picking up 2 kills at the beginning of this round. Both Rain and Jkaem both falling. And no map progress being made here either in terms of taking control.
Yeah, kind of going single file out there, just combining their way to death. Not a great deal of teamwork, no flashes over there to try and blind the CT defenders. And you still got Dennis there, who's hoping that Bubble will again show himself out in the open. But this time E-Frag playing a very disciplined round, and this is a fantastic hold for them so far. It's going to come down to G2 Kingwin having to get ridiculous entry frags. If they don't, this round is going the way of the Bulgarians once more. And that's one way to lock it down. But again, look, Fox goes by himself. The other two players are waiting behind him. They were setting up for the smokes. And so there's no unison there from G2 Kingwin. And they're just getting picked to pieces.
They're going to work their way in here. SpyleadeR is going to get dropped by Dennis off of the hinges of a great pomp flash coming through that smoke. But now they've got to combo this into a whole lot more kills because they're still down in a 2-on-4. And they're now trapped through their wedge between. Only 20 seconds left. Dennis is going to pick up that headshot, but he's down very low, down to 50 HP. And Makalele down at 25 as well, so not a whole lot of breathing or being given to these players. They've got to go for the plant. They're still closed in, too. Dennis is going to fall back, tries to get the flash on the bubble, not going to find it. He gets dropped by MKL, actually. Makalele now trying to hold this up with 8 seconds left. He's left himself no time. A very similar situation to what we had a few rounds ago, but this time he's going to make the choice to plant. But just to his left, in comes Viktor, coming through the mid-choke point. He's going to be able to very quickly dispose of him, and although we do see the plant coming out from G2, E-Frag are going to close out the round, and they're going to pick up the 15th point here.
I guess the only small saving grace for G2 Kingwin is they got the bomb planted. That allows them a few more grenades here just before Makalele's life was ended. But again, E-Frag have just stomped down. The last 8 rounds have gone the way of the Bulgarians. So that is from 12-7 to 15-12. E-Frag have been in command. Can Kingwin break that curse? Can they take us to the overtime?
And this is going to be
not looking likely.
This is just going to be pure aggression this time too from the CTs. They're going to look to throw them off completely from the beginning. It works. It's a 2-for-1, but they trade it back. And in excess too, G2's Kingwin Fox is going to find another kill over here on a victory. So they bring it into a 3-on-2, but what's unfortunate is they reveal the attentions of the T's, but in the long run of things, this actually doesn't matter just because of the fact that it's only 2 players left alive from E-Frag anyway, so they have to split it in a 1-for-1. Leaving one on site because they still don't actually know where the take is going to happen. With Fox pushing this far in, this should solidify it if NKL can pick up that kill. But at that point, it would only put it into a 2-on-1 anyway, so it's not going to be too troublesome for these guys. Fox trying to make his way, and he hasn't spotted NKL just as of yet. But NKL's attention is drawn a lot more over here towards Port, so this is going to be a dual take. A lot of pressure coming onto him. Finds one of those kills, and now can draw the rotation. Dennis gets the trade, but now Dennis looking to clutch things out here at this point. Coming in to get the plant. He's going to put it over here in the corner. And SpyleadeR working his way out too, just going to push through it, has the headshot angle, but not going to be able to find it just as of yet. And as he pushes in here, Nate going to land directly on him, doesn't actually do all that much damage, down to 72, and Dennis will indeed clutch it out there, winning the one-on-one. Kingwin, or G2, apologies, keep themselves in this game for the time being, up to the 13th point, 2 more away from tying things up and taking us into OT.
Solid round for Dennis, but they did lose quite a few weapons in the process there, 4 weapons in total, so the rebuy coming in. The issue, though, is because E-Frag won 8 rounds in a row, they can easily rebuy this round and then can force up next round as well and have a fairly decent buy again if G2 Kingwin take it. So there are no easy rounds from here on out to take us to overtime. And Bubble, I think that may be one of the first times we've seen an AWP in the hands of E-Frag on this entire map. And what a time to run the double AWP setup. Completely catches Makalele unaware. And just like that, G2 Kingwin backs against the wall once more.
It's going to catch the whole team unaware, to be completely honest. This is a really great mind game that's now been played by E-Frag, because the whole game, I'm going to be honest here, with the maybe one or two exceptions, I don't think we've seen Ops been brought into play this entire game so far. So I think G2 have just sort of realized that this is going to be something that, oh yeah, there's no Ops in place, we can make these kinds of plays. But now it's not the case. Now you have to deal with Ops, and that completely changes the dynamic of the play. So they're going to find a 1-for-1 trade on the way into this B site. They still also deal with the fact that Jacob's not even here right now. They only have two to hold this site. Jacob's still on his way from Banana. Thankfully, this does give them some security in the fact that they know there's not going to be a push coming in from there, but nonetheless, there's NKL moving, and he finds one kill. Dennis pops out, gets the trade once again, but he's playing it aggressively. Dreamer's going to be able to drop him, and now it's all in the hands of Jacob at this point. He's going to fall as well, and that's going to be the map. E-Frag strike back, and they're going to take this one 16-13.
They are, so we're going to be heading to cash with pretty much identical scores just reversed. Unbelievable from E-Frag. I did not really give them much of a hope. I said seven rounds is a solid T-half, but I was expecting the SCET side to capitulate somewhat. Not the case. I stand corrected. What a performance.
All right, guys, so that is going to close out map number two here. We're going to be heading into our third and final map, which again is going to be over on cash in just a few moments, so stick around for it. And we'll be right back with the conclusion of the set here at the StarLadder Star Series Season 14 right here on Twitch.